Please rise for a moment of silence. And now for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good morning, Jonathan Law. Today is Friday, June 3rd, and today is a senior class trip. I'm Maura. Where's McKenna?
Here, don't worry, I made it. Do you want this now?
We're rolling.
Okay.
Yeah. You got it?
Yeah, I'm good. Oh. Yes. And I'm McKenna, the Angry Eagle Eye News Translator. And here are today's announcements.
There will be a mandatory graduation practice on Friday, June 17th at 9:15 a.m. Please report to the football field.
9:15? You're telling me we have to get up at 9:15? We don't even go here anymore. This is for practicing walking in a straight line? Should we even be graduating if we can't walk in a straight line? And speaking of lines, the line at Starbucks is gonna be way too long at 9:15. It's rush hour. I'll be there by 10, maybe.
Prom pictures are now available on the Photography by Roman website. The deadline to order is next Friday. Make sure you pick up your prom photos in Mrs. Francisco's room.
Shout out to prom. Third time's a charm, I guess. And shout out to inflation. I only had to rob two banks to afford the prom tickets this year. Beautiful venue, though. The feathers were a touch, for sure.
The Advocate is creating committed posts for the class of 2022. Please email Mr. K at ckulenich@milforded.org with a photo of you wearing college, career, or military gear, and we will post your graphic on the Advocate social media accounts.
At Mr. K. Why did this announcement run for 3 months straight? No one commits to college in October, except for me and Jaden. No big deal or anything. We're not better than you, but like, maybe at sports we are.
AP payments are past due. Please see Miss Sylvia in the College and Career Center or your school counselor to pay for your exams.
How much do I have to pay to get a 5 in AP Chem? Or even just a 3 in AP Calc? Do you accept Venmo? And when is the actual due date for the AP payments? The announcement always said past due, but we never knew an actual date.
Today is the last day for the Interact Club's clothing and houseware fundraiser. Get a head start on your spring cleaning and bring in any gently used items to donate. There will be a bin in the main lobby for donations. Please see the Twitter page at JLHSInteract20 for a list of acceptable items and email Maya Schwing at schwingmaya@students.milfordet.org with any questions.
This has to be the longest running fundraiser in law history. The Interact Club has more used clothes than savers at this point. Miss Bird's room looks like a landfill of old houseware items. Also, every time Maya reads it, she reads it in the third person. That's weird.
Well, it's for the homeless,
I guess.
Today's lunch special is Big Daddy Pizza. Also available are sandwiches, salad, pizza, and chicken patty wraps.
Fun fact. Every Friday, there's a fight on set to avoid saying the words, Big Daddy's Pizza. You know what's not awkward to say? Cheese quesadillas. Can we just say that every day?
In law sports action today, baseball is home against foreign.
Dub.
Softball is home against foreign.
Dub.
Boys and girls track are home against foreign.
Double dub. Speed lives in Devon.
Girls lacrosse is home against foreign.
Dub.
Boys lacrosse is home against Wilbercross.
Not foreign.
Let's just move on.
Dub.
Golf is home against foreign.
Dub.
Boys tennis is home against foreign.
Dub.
Girls tennis is home.
Dub. We know you guys wear your SEC champ shirts every day.
Against Amity.
That's an L.
And now we have an announcement from the drama club.
Again.
Hi everyone, it has been 2 months since the Drama Club's production of Freaky Friday, so I thought we could watch the promotional video for the musical again. Enjoy!
Sophie, the show was literally 3 months ago. Get over it!
When you're spending every day on your own, and here it goes!
No! I've watched this too many times already, Sophie. At least 20. Mr. K, you have to do something about
okay, this. Okay, well, now it's time for a book talk with Law's Library Media Specialist, Miss Mundy.
Hi, I'm Miss Mundy with my book talk. First up, here is...
Wait. Let me guess. It's a book about death, destruction, anxiety, depression, violence, and death.
How'd you know? Okay, next up is...
Let me guess. Again, death, substance abuse, mental health.
How'd you know? Have you read all the books in the TLC?
Nope. I'm just here for all the book talks.
Okay, well, our third book is a happy one. I swear, the main character smiles, tells jokes, and
then they die, right?
Yes, they die at the end.
How many books do you have? The news is already over 7 minutes long. So half of my teachers have already turned it off. Wait, is it period two?
Yeah.
I didn't study, forget it. Keep going. Do you have any more? Do you have like 20? 20 would work.
I think we should probably just, like, wrap it up. Can I do the sign-out? I love doing the sign-out.
Wait, hold that thought for about an hour or so. We have a few other things to get through first. Let's do this instead.
Live from Jonathan Law, it's the Class of 2022 Senior Video!
Hello, and welcome to the Class of 2022 Senior Video. Here are your hosts, the members of the Law Broadcast Journalism Class.
Thank you, McKenna, for the delightful introduction.
Everyone, welcome to the Class of 2022 Senior Video.
We have a lot in store for you tonight, but first we should probably do some thank yous.
Maya and McKenna, take it away.
Hi, McKenna.
Hey.
We've been through a lot in the last 4 years, so we just wanted to take some time to give thanks to those who deserve it.
Let's write some thank you notes.
Wait.
We can use paper.
Yeah. Thank you to COVID for being the reason that none of our teachers knew what we looked like for 3/4 of our high school year.
Sorry to disappoint you. This is what I actually look like. The mass fishing was real. Thank you to the supply chain for canceling several quesadilla days and making the deli line stretch into the senior calf.
You ruined my hopes and dreams every single day. Less Big Daddy's pizza, more quesadilla days. Thank you to Ruz for your endless supply of math skills and Vince.
I may not know math, but at least I have good breath. Thank you to our open campus policy for making our Starbucks and Dunkin' runs every day so much easier.
Wait.
Open campus.
Thank you to Mr. Darcy for reinforcing the tardy policy on his first day as principal and turning the post road into the Indy 500 every morning.
I mean, come on, it's 7:20 somewhere. Thank you to Devious Licks and TikTok for being the reason that we could not wash our hands for the first 2 months of school.
Freshmen.
Thank you to our new school IDs for blatantly displaying every password to literally every account we have.
It seemed like a good idea at the time. Thank you to Zam Photography for proving that it's impossible to take a non-awkward picture of someone running, flipping, or swimming at full speed.
Honestly, it's just tragic. Thank you to the bathroom floors for doubling as lunch tables this year.
If you know,
you know.
Thank you to the 1 gallon water jugs for always reminding us how hydrated we don't need to be.
I mean, honestly, is this really necessary? This is just too much at this point. Thank you to the senior lot for extending the school day by an extra half hour.
If you're not running, you're not getting out of that parking lot. Thank you to the JLHS Instagram accounts for reminding us to park in the lines, not sleep in the TLC, and chew with our mouth closed.
The best part of my day is going on Instagram and seeing an unsolicited picture of my feet. It really makes me feel like a celebrity. Thank you to the people who wore their masks around their chin all year. Your neck will never get COVID.
Congrats. Thank you to Wordle for replacing doonas at the first 5 minutes of every class.
What even is epoxy?
Or nymph.
Or tacit.
Or cynic. Wait.
We have one more thank you.
Thank you to everyone who participated in our next segment.
Where will you be in 10 years?
In 10 years, you'll see me on the cover of Forbes Under 30 magazine.
In 10 years, I will be stacking mad dough.
Where I'm going to be in 10 years, I'm going to be stacking more bread than Tommy.
In 10 years, I hope to have a job, maybe a house, and a family.
In 10 years, I hope to retire from swim with the gold medal and be on The Bachelor in Paradise.
I think I'll probably be in Connecticut in 10 years, to be honest.
In 10 years, I'm probably still going to be at the Stratford Edge every day with Ellie.
In 10 years, I'm going to be living in Charleston, South Carolina. I don't really know what I'll be doing, but I'll have lots of money.
Where I want to be in 10 years is a radio station because I like music.
I think maybe in 10 years, hopefully, I'll be like writing books, comic books, maybe something like that, I guess. That'd be cool.
In 10 years, I hope to be in FBI lab working on cases.
In 10 years, Catherine's going to be a forensic psychologist.
In 10 years, Nikita is going to be a rich doctor.
In 10 years, I see myself shooting for the NFL.
In 10 years, I will be challenging Steve Jobs to a game of rock, paper, scissors for $1 million in the metaverse.
In 10 years, I'll probably still be here trying to pass Calculus BC.
In 10 years, I hope I'll be a successful person in life and not on the side of the street.
Hopefully I'll probably be in the Olympics about 10 years from now.
In 10 years, I'm going to be working on Wall Street.
In 10 years, I'll be playing pro baseball.
In 10 years, I'll be on the beach in California, hopefully getting tan, not burnt, living my best life.
In the next 10 years, hopefully I'll either be in construction or I will be a music teacher.
In 10 years, I will be working at a publishing company, editing and publishing books.
In 10 years, I hope to be writing a sitcom that'll rival Friends and The Office.
In 10 years, I'll probably just be chilling out, hanging with Lucas in Hawaii.
In 10 years, I think Madison's gonna be a travel nurse making bank in Hawaii.
10 years, I hope to know what I want to do with my life.
In 10 years, I'll be a criminal defense lawyer defending people in court.
In 10 years, I see myself living in Boston and working in a pharmacy with like a family and a dog.
In 10 years, I will be in my mansion in the Bahamas with four dogs.
In 10 years, I will be financially free and rich as hell, not working. That's the goal.
In 10 years, Lucas will still be playing football at law.
10 years, I'm going to be making bank as an occupational therapist.
In 10 years, I'm going to be rich as anything, working as a pharmacist, and changing lives.
I see myself in 10 years with this guy.
In 10 years, I'll be a marketing agent sitting front row in New York Fashion Week.
In 10 years, I'll be best friends with Luke Henriksen.
Okay, in 10 years, hopefully, I'll be a nurse practitioner making millions down south.
In 10 years, I will still be working on Ms. Corvo's capstone project.
I see myself in 10 years, hopefully, in Colorado, big house, maybe with some animals, a farm, you know, something like that.
I don't know, somewhere.
In 10 years, I'm going to have my own house, have a lot of money, and own my own business.
In 10 years, I think I'll be working as a pediatric nurse.
In 10 years, I will own my own cafe or bakery.
I think I'm going to be in a welding company in 10 years.
I'm going to be in Cody's house.
In 10 years, I will be married rich, traveling the world.
In 10 years, I'll be flying for Delta.
In 10 years, I'll have my master's in teaching, and I'll be back at law, replacing the head of the math department. Sounds about right.
Wow, the class of 2022 is really ambitious.
Let's keep those egos in check.
Now it's time for an annual senior video tradition.
Mean Tweets, Jonathan Law Edition.
At Eva Carroll, we didn't know that salutatorian meant second most absences in the senior class. Hashtag never here.
I'm on my way right now. Late, but on my way.
At Joe and Kaylee, when's the wedding? Hashtag where's my invite?
Actually, you already missed it.
At JLaw Media, I signed in. Okay, but did you though? Because you know I can see it on my computer screen right over here. I'm just gonna go check and... Oh, okay. You signed in. Good job.
At Mariah, you don't need a different pair of shoes for each outfit. Hashtag I don't even have that many pairs of shoes. Don't know what you guys are talking about.
All right, one take. Let's see what you guys got here. At McPartland, thank you for being the reason hair products were sold out everywhere during quarantine. Not bad. Listen, I think it's in everyone's best interest. I throw something up here. If not, this is what you get. But this is one of the nicer mean tweets I've gotten. You guys made me reflect a little bit. I do need to take some notes from my colleagues, maybe Mr. Regini, Mr. Batson, Mr. Rizbarski. I got to take some notes on how they do and style their hair, save myself some money.
At Shelby Green, thank you for not taking sports so seriously the last 4 years. It was nice of you to be so chill all the time.
At Mackenzie Ott, oh, didn't realize it was pajama day today, or every day. I didn't even wear pajamas every day.
At Aiden King, do you even go here? Hashtag fish school.
At Rags, never met a law quarter zip he didn't like. Hashtag Dean of Dressing Down. Let's see which one I'll wear today. I'll wear this one. That one. Walk guys, go Hawks. Law tennis. Old school one. What is that? Baseball. Basketball. Go Hawks. I think I'll choose the tennis one today.
At Emma Savoy, you couldn't let your sister keep any personal records? Hashtag sibling rivalry. Well, you know, she did have her chance, but I'm just too good.
At Jackson Waters, did you get a full ride to Hogwarts? Hashtag Harry Potter glasses. Yeah, I'm majoring in defense against the dark arts.
At Maya Schwing, you don't have to study if you don't have a test. Hashtag you stress me out. Well, the joke's on you guys. I stress myself out.
At JLHS Athletics. So, whatever happened to all those daily health screening forms? Hashtag wallpaper. Well, it's funny you should ask. So, Mrs. Cerullo and I are doing some renovations, and we have some new cabinets, and we have this new backsplash, and new countertops, and we're trying out our new wallpaper. Daily health screening forms.
At Jaden Wawoda, you're playing baseball? Holy cross? Huh? Who knew? I guess you're right. Who knew?
At Morrow Staples, it's 400 degrees in the newsroom and you still have your black puffer jacket on. Hashtag overheated.
At Mr. Beeler, wait, could you remind us where Speed lives again? Of course it's Devin. Wait a minute, Woodbine? Not a chance, even in the wood.
At Fiona the Sky, your entire wardrobe doesn't have to be black. Hashtag add some color.
At Mr. Louie, what flavor smoothie are we drinking today? Strawberry or chicken? Guys, I eat my meals just like everyone else. Look, I've got my ground turkey, got my rice, got my spinach over here. But there are times for convenience purposes where I will blend. I blended it maybe once, twice, maybe three times max. But when you're on the go, drastic times call for drastic measures, and I eat for purpose, not for pleasure. Can't argue with the results, you know?
All right, at Mr. Young, when you sweat more than all your players combined and you aren't even playing. Well, I am playing and I don't sweat. I shine.
The yearbook handed out a lot of great superlatives this year, but they definitely missed a couple of important ones.
No worries, we've got that covered. Here are our Class of 2022 senior superlatives.
The yearbook handed out a lot of superlatives this year, but we think they forgot a few.
Do you think we should hand out some more?
Sure, let's go.
There are a lot of students at law with hidden talents, including some amazing singers, but one stands above the rest. The superlative, wait, no, the Grammy for Best Hallway Singer goes to Solomon Mercado.
Each morning, hundreds of students arrive at school at 7:20. We like to call them freshmen, sophomores, and juniors. The superlative for the least likely to come to class on time goes to the entire class of 2022.
Have you ever been sitting in the TLC and got a strange notification on your phone? Perhaps from a phone labeled FBI Van 3 or your mom? Ever wonder who it could be? The superlative for most likely to airdrop an image to everyone in the TLC goes to Micah Dow. There are just some students that, when they are in class or in the hallways, need to turn the volume down. Come on, people are trying to learn here. The superlative for loudest goes to Leo Andreolis.
Some students kiss up to their teachers to try to get better grades. Others kiss up because they're too nice. Hold on. The superlative for teacher's pet goes to
Boris Staples. If you're going to dominate on the field, you have to dominate off the field. And there's never a bad time to be making gains. The superlative for most likely to be seen at the gym goes to the entire law track team.
There are a lot of upbeat, energetic members of the class of 2022, but only one whose battery is at 100% all the time. The superlative for most likely to do the worm in the middle of class goes to Michaela Sullivan.
We love spirit weeks here at Law. Pajama day, black and gold day, tacky tourist day, anything but a backpack day. Some of these days take some planning. Some of them don't, for some people. The superlative for most likely to win twin day during spirit week goes to Haley and Carrie Boyle and Jessica and Tiffany Browning.
It's important to not judge a book by its cover, but with some people, you can just tell. The superlative for the laxiest bro goes to Luke Henriksen.
Law's student help desk always comes in clutch when we have an issue with our Chromebooks. I'm sure they love getting a million tech questions every day too. The superlative for most times hearing the phrase, "Do you have an extra Chromebook charger?" goes to Gavin Keating and Andrew Rosato.
The Jonathan Law Drama Club is second to none. They're also the best at promoting their shows with videos, flyers, and social media. If there's a drama performance coming up, Law Nation knows about it. The superlative for most likely to promote a drama club production on Eagle Eye News 6 months before the show goes to Sophie Maselli.
Lapping may not technically be allowed, but some members of the class of 2022 have mastered the art of walking the halls. The superlative for most likely to get their steps in for the day goes to Isaiah Costa.
When a teacher asks the class if there are any questions, there's always one student whose questions aren't always related to what's going on. The superlative for most likely to ask random questions in class goes to Sarah Patel. In sports, the term GOAT, or greatest of all time, gets debated all the time. At Law, there's only one GOAT, and she is retiring this year. The superlative for the best goes to Miss Mannion.
The TLC is the go-to spot for seniors who have study hall, but one group of seniors spends more time in the TLC than they do in class. The superlative for most likely to get their mail delivered to the TLC goes to Jenna Wasserman, Grace Cantor, Nahitha Kothapalli, and Lucia Pino.
Speaking of the TLC, taking a nap in the Teaching and Learning Commons is a favorite activity for some members of the senior class. For one senior, though, that nap lasted a little too long. Here's what happened when she finally woke up.
Whoa, where am I?
You've been asleep for 4 years. We're about to graduate.
What? 4 years? What did I miss?
Well, first of all, the library's turned into the TLC.
What's a TLC?
Don't worry about it. Just make sure you sign in.
And no racing in the rolly chairs.
And don't you dare eat in here.
You also missed a global pandemic. No big deal or anything.
Whoa. Put your mask on.
This mask?
No, this mask.
Where did you get this? Did you just, like, have this on you?
Yeah, COVID's been pretty wild.
It was supposed to be 2 weeks, but that turned into 2.5 years. Years?
Yeah, we did distance learning for most of sophomore year, part of junior year.
And then we came back and we had half days every day.
And Wednesdays off.
Classes were pass-fail.
A 60 was an 85.
An 85 was a 100.
It also led to a lot of interesting TikToks.
What's TikTok?
It's the reason the bathrooms are locked now. Yup, devious licks. Long story.
Also, the sneaky cool cafeteria and party spot.
Don't worry, Darcy will fix it.
Who's Darcy?
Where's Fran?
Wallingford. Where's Bobo?
Wallingford.
Sunday night phone calls?
Sunday night emails.
Hey, remember when Trevor Noah made fun of Fran?
For what? Vapes, hard drives, it's a long story.
There are some things you didn't miss, though. Prom has been postponed twice.
Oh,
And prom is Cotillion now.
And Cotillion's prom.
What?
Here, do you want some breakfast? It's free now.
Free?
Lunch too. Pandemic.
Wait, it's Friday! Big Daddy's Pizza Day!
Big who?
You did miss some awesome events over the past year, though.
We won the Thanksgiving Day game and the Powderpuff game this year.
Woo!
Gymnastics won SECs twice.
Wait, I do gymnastics.
Well, congrats!
Thanks. What else is different? Are my teachers the same?
Mrs. Sipo's retired.
Miss Mannion is retiring.
Beeler grew his hair out.
He did?
No, he didn't.
Some people left and then came back.
Cam Asmussen is a sub now.
The Eagle Eye News kid?
Mike Lachavo coaches track.
The other Eagle Eye News kid?
Come on, we gotta go to class. Do you have a Chromebook charger?
Chromebook?
It started with a paper shortage. Then, you know, the pandemic.
Come on, we can't be tardy. Darcy hates it when we're tardy.
I can't believe I missed all of that in a nap.
Well, you missed a lot more than that.
Here's a slideshow to help fill in the gaps.
Take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Broken.
told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loaded merch in that 12-passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young.
Told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe.
We're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far. I guess I'm proud. At night, worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars. I've been around. I felt some pain. I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know, oh, oh, what you got, oh, oh, till it goes, oh, oh, till it's gone. Oh, oh, you don't know, oh, oh, what you got, oh, oh, till it goes.
It's crazy to think that we are graduating in just a couple of weeks.
Time has really flown by.
But that's enough of being sentimental.
We're going back to poking fun at people now.
Here are Mean Tweets, part two.
At Fockery, when you can see law from your house, but you're still tardy.
We late, but guess what? Oh, we still made it though.
At Eminelli, you know you can actually do work in the TLC. Hashtag always sleeping. You really woke me up for this.
At Mrs. Romellis, I swear I read the book. How am I failing these reading checks? Well, you're failing the reading checks because your answers are wrong.
At Katie Brewer, have you ever tried dyeing your hair? You could use a little color. Actually, I have not tried dyeing my hair. All of this on my head is natural. But what color do you think I should dye it?
At Mr. Frank, we swear we didn't make the news extra long some days to avoid going to period two. Hashtag 10-minute Thanksgiving videos. Or you're covering for your friend stuck in the Dunkin' line.
At Katie Kraft, you didn't make student council, but at least you made it into the senior video. Hashtag vote for Dan. Still put it on my college application, though.
At Dan Filoni, how did you become a class officer? That was easy. All I had to do was be Katie Kraft.
At Mr. Zura, you said sophomore year that when we graduated, you would tell us if you were Republican or Democrat. Well, hashtag red or blue. Well, I don't think you actually graduated yet, so hashtag technically not going to tell you yet.
At City Willett, it's school, not New York Fashion Week. Don't be mad Muffet's popping.
At City Simpson, those lines in the parking lot aren't there for decoration. Park in between them. Hashtag JLHS bad parking. All right, I can park when I want to. Like, I'm in the lines right now. Kinda.
At Ryan DeMiro, we would list all the things you're allergic to, but the senior video is only an hour long. Hashtag bubble boy. Thanks.
At Deodorica, 99s are okay. Free. Hashtag valedictorian pops. A 99? I've never heard of it.
At Mr. Ivanko, don't try to deny it. You were cosplaying as a stormtrooper last year. Hashtag gas mask.
At Sophie Maselli, hey, are you free later today? Or do you have a class office meeting, drama club rehearsal, tennis practice, prom committee meeting, NHS meeting, an AHS meeting, an MHS meeting, or principal's advisory committee meeting? Well, today I'm going to be at school until 8 p.m. actually, so I'm not going to be free until like 8:30. I'm coming, but then I have homework, and this will take forever. I mean, I'm free on Sundays, except that's the day where I do all of my homework for the entire week. But other than that, I'll be free, like, I know that it's like April, but like, is June okay? Like late June? I don't know. Okay, I have to go. Let me know. I'll text you later, but June, maybe.
At Russ, when you get about the volume in the TLC, but you are the volume in the TLC. Are we talking the math volume here? Are you calling me fat? You're telling me I'm as big as the TLC? That's messed up. I need to know the meaning of this. Who did this? Maura, who did this tweet, Maura? I think they're mean.
At Lauren Davis, thank you for bringing orange slices and juice box every time we go out. Hashtag mom friend. If you'll excuse me, I'm actually late to the law softball game.
Maya, you seriously woke up and chose to wear your outfit today? Are you kidding? I don't have time for you. We have to do the mean tweet. Oh, okay. At McKenna Sharp, maybe it's an issue when the mean tweets are the nice thing you've said all day. Well.
At Mr. K, not a mean tweet, just some advice. Stop drinking McDonald's coffee. Too soon.
What's up, lads? It's me, Andres Menegatos. And I got a mean tweet directed at me. It says, if I remember correctly, rally the troops, hashtag future president. And I just want to say, they're already rallied. What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
Yeah, baby, you're gonna go 2040! It's happening!
At Catherine Froley, if you call out sick, this rusty twist just goes for the day.
Yes.
At Michaela Sullivan, you bring a lot of Starbucks to school, maybe mix in a decaf once in a while. Hashtag high energy.
At Mackenzie Powers, when you need a step stool to reach the uneven bars, hashtag short gymnast problems.
You're right, a step stool, great idea. Would have made winning these so much easier.
At Mr. Darcy, how many new rules do you think you can put in before the end of this video? Well, I guess it all depends on how much time I have. I have some great ideas.
Wow, those mean tweets made me really nostalgic.
We've had a lot of ups and downs these past 4 years, but we've made a lot of lasting memories.
Now let's see what the rest of the class of 2022 is going to remember the most.
My favorite memory is all of the Jonathan Law Drama Club productions, such as The Addams Family and Freaky Friday.
My favorite law memory was coming out of the water after finishing the final lap in our record-breaking 400 medley relay.
My favorite law memory was being a running back in Powderpuff with Ellie Van Waveren.
I think my favorite law memory was any sporting event, but in particular, probably the pink out football game this year.
My favorite law memory is when I projectile vomited all over the freshman wing sophomore year.
My favorite law memory is freshman year, Julia Myers was yelling at the freshmen, and she told us to move down on the bleachers, and it was raining, and I fell down the bleachers.
My favorite memory was law swim senior night.
My favorite law memory was watching number 34 trot down the sideline in the football games. And then my other favorite law memory was my boy Aiden King playing center back for the law soccer, holding it down in the back end. I mean, it was just amazing to watch.
Hi, my favorite memory is canine catering because I get to work at a job site.
My favorite memory at law is breaking my diving record. And then again, and then again. And then one last time.
My favorite law memory was when I was at a basketball game and Mr. Young was getting mad, so he threw gum at my hair.
My favorite law memory was once after COVID started getting better that they reopened the TLC.
Favorite law memory is just all the football games and how chaotic they are.
A memory is a canine and canine and canarine.
My favorite law memory is the Hawaiian themed football game.
My favorite law moment is AP Spanish.
I'd say my favorite, like, law memory was probably when we wound up watching Shaun of the Dead in Mr. Negretti's film class, because it's, like, my favorite movie. I thought that was cool.
My favorite memory at law was working at the IT help desk.
Favorite law memory is opening a Chromebook, repairing it, and realizing that it was the wrong part.
My favorite memory at law is playing D-line for Powderpuff.
Favorite law memory is scoring a touchdown in the Thanksgiving Day game.
Yeah! My favorite law memory is when our swim coach, Rob Rosner, did a double off the diving board.
Hello.
My favorite memory at law was winning the Powderpuff game.
My favorite memory is track meets at law.
My favorite law memory is when Mr. Toussaint turned into the green guy.
My favorite law memory is Aiden King.
My favorite law memory is when Connor Larson took a dummy and put it in his chair to pretend that it was him in the class.
My favorite law memory was getting a coffee on the last day of junior year from Kean McInerney.
My favorite law moment was my first ever football game.
My favorite law memory was joining the Powderpuff team.
My favorite law memory is humanities class with mom and dad.
My favorite law memory would have to just be fun times with all my friends.
My favorite law memory is teaching Sydney Jav.
My favorite law memory was when my favorite friend since second grade committed to Yale because she's the smartest person I know.
Oh, thank you. I was just reading this book, but yeah, I can talk about me for a little bit. So
my favorite law memory is meeting Catherine Froelich and Sydney Simpson.
My favorite law memory is powder puffing.
My favorite memory was when I committed to Yale. I was surrounded by tons of support, tons of congratulations, money, Venmo requests, I mean, followers on Instagram. Everybody just started to love me, so.
Congrats on Yale.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Obviously, my favorite memory from law is the first time I ran track here.
My favorite law memory is getting to play soccer with Demi.
Favorite law memory is Mr. Dooley's freshman year history class.
Our favorite memory is Ms. Francisco's class.
Aww.
My favorite memory is when Aiden King sorted the Ankenator.
I don't have a specific one, but I do love any time I would go into Dennis Sweeney's room.
Article 36 was my favorite memory of the school freshman year.
My favorite memory is probably being on the track team. Probably some of the friends that I made there.
Our favorite law memory was the Hawaiian football game because
it was the only game we could be in the stands for.
My favorite law memory is my senior night for cheer.
Our favorite law memory was
the musical production of Freaky Friday.
Cody, what is your favorite law memory?
My favorite law memory is beating foreign on Thanksgiving my senior year. What's your favorite law memory?
Definitely when Spencer Hannon got that game-winning field goal against foreign during our Thanksgiving game freshman year.
My favorite memory at law would be any tennis away game bus.
My favorite law memory are Bobo Fridays.
My favorite memory from law is probably winning the SEC tournament last year, the tennis team.
My favorite law memory was definitely when we were at the football game and we messed up our routine because the music like stopped halfway and it was so embarrassing but so funny at the same time.
You know what one of my favorite memories of high school was? When Rags used to come onto the news and do an Ask the Dean segment.
He hasn't been on in a while, so he asked us to be in the senior video to answer one more definitely real question from a definitely real law senior.
Here's Rags with one final Ask the Dean.
What is up, class of 2022? This is the final episode for you guys of Ask the Dean. Real questions from students, teachers, and faculty. Let's get started. A lot of questions in here. Dear Rags, is your official title Dean of Students or Dean of Discipline? Either way, I know it has a lot to do with enforcing the rules. However, since Mr. Darcy came here, he has instituted many new rules and procedures, such as going to the CAF or the auditorium instead of roaming the halls first thing in the morning, a tardy policy with detentions as consequences, and classroom cell phone rules, just to name a few. You don't even worry about hats anymore. So my question is to you, what do you even do now? Respectfully, Dylan Benedetti. Dear Dylan, Mr. Darcy has instituted some long overdue policies that I agree we need here at law. These procedures have given me a lot of free time to focus on what I think is the most important job at the school, catching you and your friends leaving the building, which I think I have been very successful at. To be honest, it wasn't that hard when you guys would leave out the front door and then come back to school through the front door. Not too smart when the school has 39 other doors. Next question. Dear Rags, I know at law we welcome teacher interns like Mr. Drum, Mr. Henry, and Mr. Beardsley. I know we also have many students working at teacher's assistants getting CERTA credit. Is there any way we can get some help in the security booth for Kevin, Ryan, and I, and have a student get some hours as a security CERTA? Sincerely, Jose. Great question, Jose. Dear Jose, Mr. Hagen and I were way ahead of you, buddy. That's why we assigned Elijah to the security group periods 1, 3, 4, 6, and 8 for an independent study. Little did you know that we also developed a class for Elijah in which he earned 4 credits in AP security group. The good news is Elijah is pretty confident he scored at least a 4 on the exam. Next question. Let's keep this rolling along. Another question? Real question. Obviously. Ooh, this one's dated back to September. That's okay. Dear Rags, I will start interning and student teaching this fall. I am not quite sure what types of masks we are supposed to wear. Please let me know the different types of masks that teachers are wearing at law. Thanks for your help, Mr. Beardsley. My man. All right, Nolan, let's see what we got here. Dear Nolan, this reply will be of no value to you at this time. However, I will rate the top 3 masks here at law. Coming in 3rd place, my man Ruz. He had a combination of double mask and the shield. This is a very popular look in the welders union. 2nd place, Mr. Stanton, with the N95 Enville mask. Although he is 2nd place for masks, Mr. Stanton is 1st place for sending students to ISS for the improper wearing of masks. Rumor has it he once threw out Dia for lowering her mask to take a sip of water. Interesting. 1st place, Mr. Ivanko. Definitely the safest mask ever invented. To be honest, it's difficult for me to even make fun of this mask, since I have the exact same one. However, I bought my mask in case of the nuclear war or an apocalypse. Sorry for the late reply, Nolan, and congrats and welcome to the law faculty. Next question. Too many to choose from. Dear Rags, I am not sure if you are aware, but our Powder Puff team beat Forum this year, and I don't think we received enough credit. Can you make some type of announcement to recognize this accomplishment? Sincerely, Shelby Green. Shelby. Woo! Dear Shelby, you and all the Powder Puff girls were absolute beasts this year. Congrats on the big win. You will always remember that game. And because I am a good sport, I would like to offer a trophy to Foreign, our cross-town rivals. An itty-bitty second-place trophy. And while we are at it, I would like to congratulate another second-place finisher. Mr. Marco, congrats for coming in second place to Mr. Darcy. Maybe next time.
Those were some pretty law amazing, remember that, memories. But we all know that some of our favorite memories over the past few years have been with our teachers.
Let's give them one last opportunity to tell us how much they're going to miss us next year.
Congratulations, class of 2022. We are so happy for each and every one of you. We are so excited to hear about all of your successes. Congratulations on all of the accomplishments that you have had over the last 4 years and all the obstacles that you had to overcome to get there. Just, we could not be more proud of all of you. I hope that you take your law memories and keep them in a special spot of your heart. I know pre-calc, we haven't had a full year together, but my seniors, we had a great time. Thank you. The law soccer girls, there are no words at all. Thank you. I look forward to hearing from all of you. And just congratulations. Good luck. Keep feeling 22.
Congratulations, class of 2022. I'm so excited to watch you celebrate the close of this chapter of your life and look towards the next chapter. Remember the grace, resilience, and tenacity you showed over the past few years. Take those attributes and apply them to your future. You do that, and the possibilities for you are endless. So again, congrats. Come back and visit. You will be missed.
Hey, class of 2022. Thank you so much for the last 2 years. I've had so much fun with you, getting to know all of you. You're going to do amazing things when you leave law, and I can't wait to hear about it. So congratulations.
Hey, seniors. I can't believe your 4 years of high school are coming to an end, and boy, was it a crazy couple years there. I want to say that as a class, I loved you guys, and part of coming back from COVID was the excitement was seeing you and working with you and being with you. So I hope you enjoyed these last few senior events. I wish everybody the best of luck in the future. You have so much to look forward to. The best, I think, is yet to come. So congratulations, class of 2022.
Dear class of 2022, congratulations. You have graduated. It has been a pleasure. You are moving on. Many of us here are staying. Now is the time I must shun you.
Hi, everybody. Congratulations. I'm so excited for all of you, and I can't wait to see you graduate soon. I just want to say that it has been a great pleasure to know so many of you and to teach some of you so many times. And I'm really thankful for the students who were in my environmental club, and it's been a great time. And I hope you always know we love our amazing seniors. We love it when you visit. Please take care of yourselves, work hard, stay resilient, and just keep doing the best you can. We love you.
Seniors, congratulations. Today is the day and we are all so proud of you. I am definitely gonna miss your smiling faces running around these hallways and coming and saying hi now that we can see your faces. So make sure you come back and visit us and let us know all the great things that you're doing.
Hi, class of 2022. I just wanted to say congratulations for all of your hard work. I'm so happy that I had the chance to teach a lot of you, whether that's in Model UN or humanities especially this year. I'm so proud of all of the hard work that you've put in, and best of luck in the future.
To the class of 2022, you guys have had quite an interesting high school experience. You've seen so much change in the last 4 years that I know you'll be able to handle whatever life throws at you. I'm really sad to see you guys go, but I'm very excited to hear about all of the amazing things you're going to do. Don't forget about us here at Law. Come back and visit. Good luck and congratulations.
Hi, y'all. Miss Kelly here, wishing class of 2022 the happiest congratulations on graduating. Congratulation, if you will. And I just want to say thank you to the senior class for a wonderful year full of conversations and laughs and amazing events and wonderful sports activities and all this fun stuff that really made us feel like we were having a normal, wonderful year. You guys came back into the building in September after a tumultuous high school experience where you really became the leaders our younger students needed to show us all how we do law when we're in the building. I just want to shout out to my humanities students who really did amazing work, and their passion and their professionalism is something I was in awe of, and I just want to say thank you for a year that I will not forget anytime soon. I hope you have a most joyous and wonderful summer that leads into the best journey into adulthood, where you will continue to be the hilarious, hardworking people I know that you are. Great. Congratulations, guys. Bye, y'all.
Congratulations, class of 2022. You guys made it. You know, the senior class has been through a lot of ups and downs over the past 4 years, and it definitely wasn't an easy road. But when faced with all these challenges, you guys rose to the occasion and accomplished so many amazing things in and out of the classroom. You made us all proud, and we can't wait to see what the future holds for you. I want to give a special shout out to my tennis seniors, to the Advocate seniors, to the Eagle Eye News seniors, to the Powder Puff seniors and the Humanities seniors, period six, what's up, for all of the incredible moments and memories we've shared over the past 4 years. This is not goodbye. We don't do goodbyes around here. This is just see you soon. Come back next year, keep in touch, and come let us know about all the successes you have in the future. Good luck and have fun.
Hi, class of 2022. You made it through another tough year. Three pieces of advice for you. Find something you love to do, work hard at doing it, and make sure you have some fun along the way. Congratulations.
Hi, seniors. Congratulations. You did it. You're here. You're at the end. The last few years have definitely shown us a lot of trials and tribulations, and you persevered and overcame, and here you are about to graduate. So I wish you all the best of luck and take forward everything we've taught you, everything you've learned, everything you've strived for, and head on out into the world and do awesome things. I know you will. Congratulations.
Hi, seniors. Congratulations on your graduation. You've had a rough few years. I'm hoping that things have felt more normal for you as your time at Law has come to a close. To those of you that I had last year, I want to thank you for being a bright spot during a dark time. I'll hold all of you close to my heart because you guys are the ones who got me through a tough school year last year. The strength and resiliency you have all shown over the past 4 years is going to take you far in the years to come. I'm so excited to see where all of you end up, and whatever path you take, I hope you find yourselves feeling happy and successful. I don't want to say goodbye, but I want to say whatever your next step is, be good, have fun, and make sure you come back and visit. I'll miss you guys. Bye.
Congratulations, the class of 2022. I wish you guys nothing but health and happiness in the coming years. Make sure you come back and visit.
What is up, Jonathan Law High School seniors, class of 2022? What a ride these last 4 years have been. Certainly not easy by any stretch of the imagination. I want to wish you guys nothing but the best and whatever your future holds. Please do not be strangers. Come back and visit. Go be great. Continue to crush things like you've been doing. And just know that because of your time here and what you guys have been through, you are ready for whatever life has to throw at you. Don't be surprised if you change the world one day. McParlin out.
Hi, this is Miss Mannion. You know me. I had a lot of you when you were sophomores. I can't believe you're seniors graduating from Jonathan Law High School. I wish you all the best. You've been through a lot with COVID and a war in Europe, and I'm so proud of you, and I wish you all the blessings that the world has to offer. Good luck. Stay in touch. Love you.
Hi, seniors. It's Miss Mundy here. Congratulations on your graduation. I'm so proud of you all. This is such an exciting time for you, so take it all in and enjoy the next part of your life. Congrats to the Law Class of 2022.
It's my music seniors, the Class of 2022. I hope you guys have the best of luck in the rest of your life, and I hope you guys find happiness in whatever your next steps are. And it has been a pleasure to teach you guys for the last couple years here. And thank you so much for being a part of my life. I can't wait to see what you guys do.
Hey, seniors, it's that time of year again. I get to say goodbye. And man, can I tell you, I am so excited to say goodbye. I mean, answering the same math question, how many times? Whoo! Oh, it takes a lot up here. You know, it takes a toll, guys. I mean, come on now. It's been, well, let's see here. 1 + 0.75. Minus one, you know, plus one. It's been about 3 years together. And, you know, answering the same question a lot gets tedious. But that being said, you know, it's been great. Have my classroom back, you know. Shout out to Mr. Hoggett. This is fantastic. Look at this. You know, you guys definitely helped me make it a home again. It was lovely. You know, it's still not done, thanks to you-know-whos. But besides that, I've loved all of our conversations. We've had a blast together, and, you know, our 3 years, you know, three. But I've talked a lot with you guys. You know, I'm really going to miss every single one of you. And, you know, all I'm going to say is, like I say pretty much every year, I just really hope you guys actually pay attention to it. You know, I'm still going to be here. Stop back. See your family. Love you guys. And, you know, in the next chapter of your life, just remember, drop a question, and I'm here to answer it for you.
Congratulations, class of 2022. You've made it to the end of your high school career and you're about to graduate. You should be so proud of yourselves. We're all very proud of you. It's been a crazy couple of years, but we've made it through. It looks like things are going to start being more normal, and I'm so happy that you guys are going to be able to go off to college and have a great, normal college experience. So take care of yourselves, work hard, have fun, be safe, and make sure you keep in touch with us. Take care.
You guys have had a crazy 4 years at Jonathan Law. You're a great group. I appreciate you guys. You can hear my dog crying about it in the background. But I wish you guys all the best of the luck, my AP Psych kids, my basketball kids. All the best in the future and everything you do. Make sure you come back and say hello.
Hello, class of 2022. This is your senior farewell from me. However, at Law, it's more like I'll see you pretty soon. I really just wanted all of you to know that the class of 2022 is so extremely impressive and amazing to me. You all made the past 4 years very enjoyable, really except for your freshman year when most of you were knuckleheads and out of control. But to be honest, you matured a lot and you persevered through a lot, especially with COVID and the other obstacles that you had to face. And this says a lot about really who you are and a lot about your character. So please have a fun and safe summer. And give it your all next year, no matter where it is or whatever you're doing, all right? And I just want you to know that I'll miss you all a lot. Take care.
Class of 2022, man, have you guys been through a lot. From a normal freshman year to a sophomore year that ended early and had no spring season to a very abnormal junior year. And this year has been progressively better, and we're just about back to normal now. And we're just so proud of you, the way that you overcame everything and every obstacle that was thrown your way. We had a lot of accomplishments on the court, in the pool, and on the fields, both individual and team-wise, and we know that the way you persevered will lead to success in whatever everybody decides to do in the future. So best of luck to everybody. Thank you for everything that you've given to Jonathan Law over your 4 years. And remember, once a lawman, always a lawman.
Seniors, it has been a great 4 years working with you as your administrator. I've had such a great time with many of you over the past 4 years. Please remember all the good times you had here at Law. Make sure you come back and visit us and let us know how you're doing. And always remember to wear your black and gold. Talk to everyone soon. Bye now.
Class of 2022, here we are after a great 4 years. I just wanted to say thank you for everything that you've done for our school. You have really embodied what it means to be a lawman. Congratulations and good luck in whatever you choose.
To the class of 2022, thank you for welcoming me into your school over the past few months. It's been an honor to get to know you and learn from you. You have persevered through many obstacles over the last couple of years and came out on top. I look forward to hearing what you accomplish in the future. Stay in touch, and no matter what, wherever you go, you always have a home here at Jonathan Law High School. Congratulations.
And that's our show for the year. If you want to rewatch today's episode, or if you ever miss an episode of Eagle Eye News, go to youtube.com/JLHS Eagle Eye News. Have a great summer, and congratulations to the class of 2022.